Hello students, welcome back to your science online class. Today I will be teaching you digestion of food. For this digestion, where does it start? It starts from the mouth and ends in anus. So what are the different parts of this digestive system? The different parts of digestive systems are mouth, teeth, food pipe, stomach, this is your stomach, then small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. So where does the food enters from? The food enters from your mouth, then it moves to the food pipe and then slowly to the stomach, then it moves to the small intestine, then it goes to the large intestine, and then the excretion comes out from the anus. Let us start from the very beginning. The organs of our body that helps in digestion constitute the digestive system. This system consists of mouth, teeth, food pipe, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. Digestion of food. Food is broken into smaller and simpler pieces inside our body, where it is used to provide energy. So the food what we are eating cannot be just directly absorbed by our body or directly used by our body for making of energy. So what it is done, what it happens, the food is broken down into smaller and simpler pieces, which is then absorbed and then give us energy. This process of breaking down food is called digestion of food. After taking food in our mouth, we chew, tear and grind it. So we chew, tear and grind it. Then we have the saliva in our mouth. Where does it comes from? It comes from salivary gland. So salivary glands present in our mouth secretes a liquid called saliva. It mixes with the food in our mouth to make it soft. Our tongue helps to swallow this food. Saliva starts the process of digestion in the mouth. So all this breaking of food into simpler and smaller particles is done in the mouth itself. By whom? By the teeth. And the swallowing is done by the tongue. Okay, then we will come from the next part. From the mouth, food passes into the stomach through the food pipe. This food pipe. See, from here mouth, and then it is going through the food pipe to what? To stomach. The stomach is a muscular bag where food is broken down further. In the stomach, food is mixed with the digestive juice and then passed into small intestine. Here digestive juice is present. All the names of the digestive food and what more is going on, some other products which are secreted by the different organs, all this you will learn in your next class. For the basic learning, you have to learn only these names. These few names. So what digestion is done, after the digestion is done in the stomach, the food passes to the small intestine. The small intestine is a long coiled tube whose inner wall secretes a juice that digests food further. After the half digestion is done in this stomach, the food is transferred to small intestine. In this small intestine, another digestive enzymes are secreted, so and that makes the food to digest more, to break into simpler substance. The small intestine done this part. Then liver and pancreas also part of the digestive system. Where is liver? This is the liver. This liver and also the pancreas is here. This pancreas and liver also helps in digestion. All through the food does not pass through them. they secrete juice that helps in digestion. So food does not pass through liver and pancreas. What they do? They produce some juices which help in digestion. The juice secreted by the liver is called bile. So the juice secreted by liver is called bile, whose function is to break down fats. Bile, along with other juices, changes food into a semi-liquid substance. This digested food is absorbed by the blood and carried to different organs of our body. The part of the food that remain undigested passes into the large intestine. So after what is not digested is passed to the large intestine. You can see this. This is the large intestine. The large intestine is a tube-like organ like the small intestine, though shorter than it. Water from the undigested food gets absorbed by the blood vessels in it. The semi-solid undigested food that is left behind gets sorted in the rectum as stool or feces. The stool is discharged through an opening called the anus. So what happens? In your mouth you take the food, you chew it, you grind it, and then it moves down to food pipe with the help of tongue. Means you are swallowing it with the help of tongue. And in this process, in this meantime, what is secreted in the mouth from the salivary gland? Saliva is secreted and then it is passed to food pipe. After food pipe, the food is transferred to stomach. Then from stomach to the small intestine. Within this time, liver and pancreas secrete some juices which help in digestion, further digestion. And then the other digestion is done where? In small intestine. Now which is not digested, all those food and what we have to excrete out goes to large intestine. In this large intestine, water is absorbed. Our body needs water. With the food what we are drinking or what we have is absorbed in the large intestine. Then the excreted part, complete excretion, what is left, that is excreted by anus. And that excretion is known as stool or feces. I hope you understood this. Now we will go to the next topic. So our next topic is preparing food. So what we eat is either we eat raw or sometime we eat by cooking it. So we eat raw as well as cooked food. Fruits and certain vegetables are eaten raw. We should wash them properly before eating so as to free them from dust and germs. Some fruits are generally eaten raw. So before eating them, you need to wash them properly with water and to clean them and to make them dust and germ free. Next, we eat some food boiled, some as steamed, roasted or fried. All these processes of cooking makes food soft, tasty and easily digestible, and also kills the germ in the food. Now preserving food. Everyone need to preserve food so that they don't get spoiled. Food is very valuable for us. At right now, in this lockdown situation, we need to preserve some food. And also give, if you preserve them or if you have enough amount of food, give to the poor people, those who can't have enough amount of food. And even you can give to the dogs, stray animals and cats and all. So food is very valuable. If not preserved, it may be spoiled. The process of treating food in a way that preserves its value for a long time is called preservation. So what is preservation? Preservation is a process where you can preserve your food by different process. For example, you add salt and oil to the pickles so that it is not destroyed. For long time, it can be used and you can eat throughout the year. So these are few examples. These are like examples. So you will get to know more when you will start your classes or in your higher studies. Now let's learn something which is very important while you cook food. Do not throw away the water in which pulses are soaked. It contains vitamins, so you can use that water again for cooking. Do not wash vegetables and fruits after cutting them. While boiling, just take enough water so that the water which has absorbed the nutrients is not thrown away. So don't take excessive water. Take a perfect amount so that that is absorbed by the food itself and then you can consume it. There should not be extra water which you throw away. Then do not overcook. Too much roasting and frying destroys the nutrients. So do not fry too much. Don't cook or overcook the food or boil again and again, again and again. Don't do that. So do it till and limit. And so because it destroys all the nutrients. Now let's revise the whole chapter once again. Food help us to grow, gives us energy and keep us healthy. Point number 2. Carbohydrates and fats give us energy and keep us warm. Third point, protein help us to grow. Fourth, vitamins and minerals keep us fit and healthy. Digestion is a process of changing food into a simpler form that can be absorbed and used by the body. Digestive juice from mouth, stomach and small intestine help us to digest food. Cooking makes food soft, tasty and easily digestible. Cooked or uncooked food can be preserved in different ways. So these are the thing. I will be again giving all this writing to you in your video. And in your next class, we will do all the question answers. Till then, stay safe, stay at home. Goodbye.